And here's a copy of our example program now in Visual Studio 2019. So I've created a new project. It's called it Console Application 13, and I've copied our program into here. So we still need to create this input.txt. So we're going to go up to File, then we're going to go to New, and then we're going to go to File. There's a couple of different ways to do this in Visual Studio, but I think this is maybe the most straightforward. We'll select text file and then click open and then go back to save text file as, and then it should pop up in your repository folder. So we just need to find our project, and then we're going to save it inside the internal project folder. So this is Console Application 13, and then there's another folder in there called Console Application 13. And again, make sure that your extension matches the extension that you're using inside your program. So we'll type in the same input. Leave that same blank line. Just like with code blocks, see this yellow line here? It means that this file has not been saved yet. So we need to click the save icon, just the floppy disk icon. That bar is now turned to green. And we can go back to our code and go to debug and then start without debugging. So it found our input file and it read from it. Same thing, we crashed the stream, and so we just got the same last number twice. Now let's go find our output file. So file, and then open, and then file. It should pop up right into the Console Application 13 folder, but again, if you have to look for it, it should be in your repository folder. And notice that we're too deep into Console Application 13, the number 2. So there's the outer folder, Console Application 13. We're in this inner folder, Console Application 13. And then there's our output file, output.txt. So let's click on Open, and then it'll open right up in here. Usually Visual Studio will give you some kind of warning message. Let's see if it changed it. And let's go back and verify. Yeah, in this version, it's linking it in and making the change automatically without prompting you for a warning message. But depending on your settings, if you do get a warning message about do you want to change, just click yes or yes to all, and then it should update your output file each time you run your program. So again, you can see this is very similar to what we went through with code blocks, but slightly different. Each IDE is going to be slightly different about how you add and link in the files. So if you do have problems with Xcode, try and look for some videos. Unfortunately, I don't have a Mac to be able to do an Xcode demo for you. But if you look at some demo videos on YouTube, I'm sure that there are plenty with Xcode to show you how to create the text files, and then also where the text files get saved. Thanks for watching.